Yo, what's going on, man? I am Michael Lee. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I want to thank y'all for tuning in. And, So, you guys got any questions, comments, anything like that? Just want to say you can head to my Instagram at MichaelLee01984. And I'll be gladly to answer them, okay? Apologize for the bump on my nose. Anyway, I'm okay, just, you know, it's just there. It is what it is. Alright, cool. Yeah. Used to it. It's gonna be a minute before I post another YouTube video. Nothing's wrong with nothing like that. It's just, in my opinion, YouTube is dead. Yeah, sometimes I get like that. And, like, what it takes to make a YouTube video. Hold on. Let me drop some music. Hold on. Now, drop some background music, okay? And, like, what it takes to do a YouTube video. Like, you want something to come out of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, for me, it's when people come to my YouTube channel. You know what I'm saying? It's traffic. Like, I want people to come to my YouTube channel. I want people to watch it. I want people to like my videos. Stuff like that. It's not about subscriptions. You know what I'm saying? Like, some people like people to subscribe to each channel. For me, it's about people that like my videos. Or if they dislike them. Or if they comment on them. Stuff like that. That's what I like. You know what I'm saying? That's what my hopes and dreams and aspirations for stuff when it comes on YouTube when it comes to comments and when it comes to likes. That's what I want, is YouTube traffic. I don't care about subscriptions, because for me, that leads to stuff. You know what I'm saying? That leads to, like, product placements, people being like, I wonder, huh, this person on camera, who they is and what they do. Then you be like, well, I'm such and such, and this is what I do, and this is where I'm from, and that kind of stuff right there. And you can be like, okay, this is what I do, and okay, so this is what I got. Are you interested? That's how you pull them in. And so that's kind of me. And so some people might just like subscriptions, because they be like, you know what, I want people to subscribe to my channel so I can get the play button and all that. No big deal. But me, I like the traffic, because, you know, numbers don't lie, and, you know, that's kind of what makes it better for me. But anyway, you see the title, you see the thumbnail, and this one, it's kind of like personal for me, because it's something that I'm passionate about. This video is advice, and it's called 0 to 21 Knots. Alright. 0 to 21 Knots. It's just because I'm doing an ebook, okay? And this is kind of retail related, because I'm going to sell my own ebook. And if y'all don't know what that is, it's like a book you can read online. And it's not going to be like totally, it's not going to be expensive. It's going to be like under like $8, it's gonna be like $5, something like that. But I have like a passion for yachts and water and stuff like that. So what I want to do is I want to show the average person that if you be like, you know what, man, I want to own my own yacht, I want to show you that you can go from $0 to owning your own yacht and being on the water like that. I'm not saying it's gonna be fast, but it's not gonna take long either. It's gonna be like 60-90 days, and bam, you're on your own yacht. You own your own yacht. You ain't chartering it, you ain't renting it, you know, you're not trying to co-broker it with nobody else. And I'm not saying you're gonna be rich, you know what I'm saying? But I'm saying you're going to be like, 0 I got $0 in the bank to there she blows. I got to get it on the port side. I got to make sure everything on the port side is straight. I got to make sure all my lines on the bow. I got to make sure I got gas in the tank so I can go where I want to. Or I got to make sure my mast is in the right place if I want to sail on yacht. Yeah. Because that's something I'm passionate about. Because that's my hope, dream, aspiration in life. Because I'm a yacht person. I love yachts. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to yachtword.com and shout out to James Dish, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to AV Bodger, that's all I'm going to say about that. I want to make this video because I got a new ebook that I'm doing, and I want to let y'all know, you don't have to be rich to have your own yacht, you know. You know, before people be like, oh, you got your own yacht, you got to be rich. You ain't got nothing to do with that. Does not have anything to do with that, okay? All you got to do is look at it, line it up, then go for it. All right? And don't let nobody deter you, okay? Don't let nobody deter you. All right? And I'm going to kind of give y'all a few hints, like a few thumbnails or whatever you want to call it, and then we can get up out of here, okay? Now, let me tell you something. It's no building up when it comes to this yacht stuff, okay? You either go for it or you don't, because you'll get stuck, all right? So, it's no building up to your own big boat. You know, I've heard people be like, you know, I'm going to just start with this my own little speed boat, my own little fishing boat, and then build to a yacht. No. Because you'll get stuck. What you do is you do your research. First you gotta be like, you know what? I want this type of boat. Meaning, I want a sailboat or either I want a motor yacht. Because I don't believe in houseboats. That's just kind of whack. That's trash. You don't need. You either want a sailboat or a motor yacht, okay? And once you choose which one you want, you gotta choose what brand you want, okay? Now, when you choose what brand you want, you gotta choose, like, two of them. Because one not gonna fall through, because I had this problem. I chose Azmite, Azmite. All right, and I forgot the other Ray something. I forgot what it was. The first one was that was the first one. All right, and the first one was Azmite. All right, and that's the main one for me because I like them. I like how it look. I like the technology it has on there. It's not over technology-wise, you know what I'm saying? It's just right. Yeah, C-Ray. Yeah. I like C-Ray as well. And you gotta kind of choose what your price range is. Now, it's yachts that's like $50,000, $200,000, millions of dollars. Me, personally, you know what I'm saying, I wouldn't pay more than, like, maybe $580,000 for a yacht. And I don't mind buying used. I wouldn't mind buying a used yacht. Because it's something that I wouldn't mind doing. Like, and you gotta say, do you want other people to help you with your yacht? Or you do it yourself? I do it myself. Now, when you get to the millions of dollars a yacht, then you're going to need a whole team and stuff like that. But me, I would say I would have a working, me, mine would be a working yacht. Because me particularly, I'm going to want to do it myself. I'm going to want to get in there myself, put the oil in it myself, shine everything myself, sweep it myself. Because, it, yeah, Because this ain't got nothing to do with nothing but adventure and seeing the places and hearing the sounds and that kind of stuff. But if you wanna just be like, you know what, I just wanna feel it would like to be rich, go ahead on, but you're gonna have to pay them rich bills. There's nothing wrong with that. You can do it with this ebook that I'm coming out with. You just gotta kinda allot the money for it. There's nothing wrong with that. That means you just gotta choose what. And some people might just be like, you know what, man? I want me a yacht so I can fish. Because I like to fish. Or I want me a yacht so I can explore. And because I like to, I'm a scientist. And I want to travel and, take samples of water and fish and pollution and whatever. And seismic activity. You know, in different places. Or, you know, and dive up under the water. So, different reasons why somebody would want a yacht. And so, I'm going to cover this in my ebook. You know? And it's not going to be big or long because I don't like the... Something simple and straight to the point. You know what I'm saying? And so, this is going to be either coming out sometime this year or the beginning of next year, like in January. And so... Like I say, it's going to be called 0 to 21 Knots. And I have done something like this before. So this is like my second installment. First one went away quite well. But yeah. And the last thing I want to tell you before I go, because like I said, I don't like having long videos. Because it takes long to upload. And I don't like it take for a long time to upload because I watch my stuff upload. Because... Sometimes you can be like, well, yeah, I'm finna just push it, upload, and just walk away, do something, do my laundry, go get something to drink, get high. No, I'm just saying, don't do drugs. I'm just saying. And then you come back, and you be like, huh? And you upload. So I watch all my upload, just to make it sure. But you will need paperwork. Paperwork is key. Okay? I have what you would call a yacht info page. And what that is it has my name on it, some personal information, it's put up safely somewhere, and it also has why I want to get into it, why I want to have my own yacht, or get into yachting, it has the type of yacht that I want, all that kind of stuff. It has my hometown, all that kind of stuff. And so you're going to need that, because... You can't just go around and sail. You have to have permission to go into different marinas and docks, into different ports and different stuff like that. Not to all of them, but some of them. And when you go into these places, they'll need to know who you are. And so that's documentation. So you'll need to know. So I have a yacht page. I mean, I have a yacht info page. And so it took me time to do that. So you gotta have something on that. Got your name, phone number, address, next to kin, what kind of yacht you know that you're interested in having or that you have. All that kind of stuff has to be on one page. And it has to have the year that you did this, all of that kind of stuff. And it has to be current. Because you are going to a docking space that belongs to other people. All right? Just like if you want to go to Jamaica. Or if you want to go to Cancun. Or if you want to go to Africa. Or if you want to go to Mexico. All those places, that belongs to them. So you're in their area. So they need to know who you are, where you come from, and what you have. So it's not enough just to say, oh, well, here's my ID or here's my passport. They need to know who you are. They need to know what vessel that it is, what kind it is, all that kind of stuff. Because it's important. And how I know that? research. But yeah, that's about it. So yeah. So it's coming later on. So thank you all. Have a great day. I hope this video was informal and helped you out. Comments, hit me up. Questions, hit me up. On my Instagram at MichaelLee01984. So thank you and have a great day. Good evening.